Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Nasrin Parasale. In today's video, we are going to continue the last part of the video. Since you all know we are discussing the answers for various questions that are asked in GATE Biotechnology 2021. As you all know, question paper has this response sheet link has been generated, and if you didn't watch your responses, please go and watch. So this is one question asked. The process by which intracellular macromolecules are supplied for lysosomal degradation during nutrient starvation is? The correct option is autophagy, because as you see the word lysosomes, definitely you will click option number 2. But they are saying intracellular macromolecules, and also this autophagy is an intracellular degradation system with which cytoplasmic contents are degraded in the lysosomes, dynamically induced by nutrient depletion in order to provide the necessary amino acid within the cells, like yeast cells, thereby helping them to adapt to starvation. So the correct option is option number 2. Next thing is that match the hypersensitivity types in group 1 with their corresponding condition in group 2. So group 1 type 1 hypersensitivity is IgE mediated, and it is also responsible for the allergy kind of thing. And the option number 2 will be correct, because host reaction to B venom, and here P is having 3, so we can delete this option. So among this 3, any one option will be the correct one. So the next thing is that type number 2. So type number 3 is mediated by antibody dependent cell mediated cytotoxicity, and the example of type 2 hypersensitivity is your erythroblastosis phthalysis. The type 3 is mediated by immune complex mediated in the presence of complement, and the correct option is systemic lupus erythematosus. It is also an autoimmune disorders. Okay. So next thing is the type 4, which is a tuberculin reaction. So it is also a delayed type hypersensitivity. So the correct option is option number 4. Okay. So based on this question, you can predict in GATE or in CSAL, even simple things can be asked, but few people will get collapsed of this type 2 and type 3. Okay. So don't lose marks in these questions also. Okay. Next thing is that which one of the following is correct about the microbial growth medium? ST agar is a differential medium. It is a wrong, because it is a general medium used for culturing the dermophytes. And also differential media is nothing but it is a bacteriological growth media, and it will contain specific ingredient that will allow one to distinguish the selected species of bacteria by visual observation. And it is also used to distinguish between the closely related organisms. For example, for your blood agar medium. Next, Luria Brettani broth is a synthetic medium. It is also a wrong answer. It is not a synthetic medium. Okay, next thing is that tryptocase soy agar is a complex medium. No, it is also a wrong option. It is not a complex medium. Tryptic soy agar is a complex medium, and the correct option is option number 4. That is, your nutrient medium is a defined medium. The content present in the nucleon broth are clearly defined even in the box itself. So the correct option is your nutrient broth. Next thing is that order of gene present in the chromosome is as follows. So they given an order of gene, consider this as a centromere, and this is a short arm, and this is a long arm. Which one of the following rearrangement represents a paracentric inversion? So you all know paracentric inversion doesn't include your centromeres. So we can see the option. So this is one kind of inversion. This is not a correct option. Next thing is that can able to see over here. Here it is inverting, because here it is including the centromere. It is a pericentric inversion. This is an option is wrong. This might be correct, because see here the segment over here, that is PO and OP and PO is 3. So the correct option is option number 2. And this option is also wrong. This is a kind of duplication event where this allele and this allele is duplicating. There is no inversion been occurring. This option is also a wrong option, because it is a kind of a translocation kind of thing where there is no inversion of segment. So the correct option is option number 2. Next thing, the enzyme which add a phosphate group to the free 5' terminus of the DNA sequences. So first you should know, enzyme which add a phosphate group is your kinase group. Okay. And phosphatase is an enzyme which will remove the phosphate group. Okay. Polynuclear kinase is an enzyme which adds a phosphate group to the free 5' terminus of a DNA sequences. So the correct option is option number 1. And this adenosine kinase is not a correct option. Alkaline phosphatase is involved in removal of phosphate group, and it is also used in nicking reaction and also in labeling of DNA, they will use this particular alkaline phosphatase and they will remove the phosphate group so that there will be the plasmid won't be re-ligated together. Okay, definitely we'll discuss this particular enzyme separately in our YouTube channel. Last thing is the terminal deoxynucleotide transferase. So you may get collapsed with this and this. So TDT catalyzes addition of nucleotide to the 3' terminal of molecule, and this TDT is generally used in polyadenylation step in eukaryotes, because this TDT is used for transferring a stretch of adenine, that is polyadenine trail in an mRNA of eukaryotes. Next thing is that which one of the following technique is not used for inserting the foreign gene to cell? Definitely the correct option is DNA microarray, and other techniques like electroporation, microinjection, gene gun are highly used for inserting the foreign gene into cell, like they are used in genetic engineering, whereas my DNA microarray is used for gene expression studies. A protein without its phosphatic group is called this. So definitely this will be a collapsing thing. Definitely you all will click option number 3 since they are staying follow, but the correct option is option number 4, because a holo protein is nothing but it is a conjugated protein. It is an apoprotein combined with a prosthetic group, whereas your apoprotein is a protein part of the enzyme without a characteristic prosthetic group. So the correct option is here option number 4. Then also lipoprotein and hemoprotein are nothing, they are biologically active protein, and lipoprotein are a macromolecule complex of lipid and protein that they originate mainly from the liver and intestine, and they are involved in transport of the lipid molecule in the bloodstream and plasma. Heme protein are a class of protein that the name implies they contain a heme group ion containing element. So the option number 4 is the correct one. Next thing is that this question might be confusing, or you will see, on seeing this question, you may think, okay, definitely this question we don't know the answer, but it's the simplest question. In Neurospora casa, a mutation in the POKI gene results in slow growth phenotype called POKI. The result of flow crosses are given below. So these are the 4 crosses and their result. Which of the following explains the inheritance mode of POKI? Okay, you should know wild type, all progeny are white. And wild type, this is a female and this is a symbol of male. You should know that first. Wild type female and mutant type male, all progeny are wild type. Okay, even though male is having this mutant type, all progeny are wild type. But consider this POKI female crossed with wild type of male, all progeny are POKI. Okay, so this POKI female, so the gene on inheritance is with respect to the maternal, that is female side. So on seeing it, you may get confused whether it is an X-linked inheritance or mitochondrial inheritance. Okay, so there is a paper website in the internet also. It is an PNAS paper, I think so. And the title of the paper is that defective production of mitochondrial ribosome in the POKI mutant of Neurospora. If you visit the paper, you will get the answer from it. So a strain of this Neurospora containing a cytoplasmic mutant affecting a mitochondrial function. Okay, it's shown to be deficient in a smaller ribosomal subunit in the mitochondria during the exponential growth phase. And this ribosomal defect shows an extra-chromosomal pattern of inheritance. Extra-chromosomal pattern of inheritance of crosses. Extra-chromosomal means your episomal. Your episome is an extra-chromosomal kind of thing, where your plasmid is an episome kind of thing. Episomal pattern of inheritance and cross of POKI with wild types. So the correct option is option number 1, episomal inheritance. So once you might definitely these kind of things won't be really well-known concepts, because these concepts are not we aware of, but you should know this concept. It is an extra chromosomal kind of thing. Your episomal is an extra chromosomal, like plasmid is an extra chromosomal thing, na? So I think so it is an episomal inheritance, or else it might be an mitochondrial inheritance, since they are having a maternal inheritance or not, but I'm not sure. I'm saying option number 1 is correct. Cellular process with utilize RNA-induced silencing complex, that is RASC, to block gene expression is. So definitely it is not an RNA splicing, or it is not an RNA pyrylation. Within RNA editing or RNA interface, any two options will be correct. So RNA interface, it is a biological process in which RNA molecule will inhibit the gene expression or translation. It is widely used in post-transcriptional gene silencing or quelling in plants. Okay, so one also Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicines have been awarded to RNA interference. And this RNA-induced silencing complex is a multi-protein complex that is mainly functioning in gene silencing, and it generally uses the small interfering RNA and microRNA for blocking. So the correct option is option number 3, which is uses this RNA-induced silencing complexes. And max separation method with a group of group 2. So centrifugation is based on density, so P is 1, so we can delete the option number 1 and option number 3. Dialysis is based on diffusivity. Okay, so I think you might get worried of this size. So dialysis is diffusivity, because dialysis separation technique that facilitate the removal of small unwanted component from the macromolecule in solution by selective and partial diffusion through a semi-permeable membrane. And this dialysis is generally used for our protein purification and many other things. So the correct option is the diffusivity. Solvent extraction is your solubility. Ultrafiltration is your size. So the correct option is option number what? Option number P is size. Centrifugation is size, and the correct option is your option number 3. Okay. Which one of the following statement is incorrect about hybridomasel? Hybridomasel can use hypoxanthine thymide. Yes, it is present in heart medium. DNA synthesis in myeloma cell is blocked by amniotin. Yes, it is also correct. So that myeloma cells cannot be able to replicate, and it is also HGPRT minus. Polyethylene glycol is used to fuse myeloma cell to B cell. It is also correct. And the incorrect statement is hybridoma cells are generally used to produce monoclonal antibody. But they say here it is used for polyclonal antibody. So option number 4 is the incorrect statement. Next thing is that plant hormone and their statement. Abscisic acid is, they say, which is a correct option? Abscisic acid breaks the seed dormancy. No, abscisic acid is a hormone. It is called as growth inhibiting hormone, and it generally promotes the seed to be dormant. Okay, the option number P is wrong. Auxin induced cell division, yes, it is a correct thing. Auxin induced cell division and apical dominance, everything, this auxin is playing real role. So Q option is correct. Ethylene is stimulate the ripening of fruit, correct. So both option number Q and option number R are correct. Gibberellin promotes seed emission. No, gibberellin will deactivate the seed dormancy, and it will lead to producing plants taller and taller. So option number 3 is the correct option. So enzyme that transcribes the eukaryotic gene encoding the precursor ribosomal RNA. So they are asking which enzyme transcribe the ribosomal RNA, and given these all are the component of larger subunit of eukaryotic ribosome, that is 50S ribosomes. So the RNA which is involved in transcribing all are your ribosome, RNA polymerase number 1, which is involved in transcribing larger ribosomal RNA. RNA polymerase 2 is involved in transcribing your pre-mRNA, small nuclear RNA and small nuclear RNA. RNA polymerase 3 is involved in transcribing tRNA, small nuclear RNA and small ribosomal RNA, that is your 18S rRNA. And the RNA polymerase 4 is generally used in your plant. Okay, these are the questions and answers, predicted answers for GATE Biotechnology 2021, and I will post numerical answer type of questions and some other bioprocessing problems in my video. For that, you need to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Only then you can get the video what I am posting. So, thanks for watching, friends.